We are back today. I definitely went to a show last night. Oh. Hey guys, what's up? It's Liz, and today I am going to be talking about new music that has been released within the past few weeks. I know last month I did this video, and it was basically the last video that I posted on this channel. It's been a wild past few weeks in my life. It's been a little hectic, but it's slowed down and I finally have time to film, which is insane. I don't ever have time to film anymore and it's so heartbreaking, but we are back today. I definitely went to a show last night. Oh, ouch. Okay, well, that's that. I believe the last time I talked about music was maybe before Grayscale's album was released, and I think probably Taylor Swift. So, let me write down a list of a few albums that we're gonna talk about, and then we'll get into it, okay? I'll be right back. So I'm back. I picked out a few records that came out this past month. We're just gonna cover three albums that I have been enjoying listening to lately, along with a few singles. Yeah, we're just gonna talk about some new releases that have been released this past month. We're gonna start with Sleep On It, because this record has honestly blown me away. Like, I don't even know what it is about this record. Yes, I am friends with the guys in the band, but this is probably one of my favorite releases this year. The whole album is so cohesive with each other. Nothing sounds the same. All sounds perfect together. Like, I feel these songs kind of complement each other in this record. A few of my favorites are After Tonight. That was the single they released before the album came out. I think maybe a few days before the album came out. It's one of my favorites on the album. It's incredible. Logan Square. It kind of makes me happy just hearing the song and a little bit emotional. And The Cycle of Always Leaving. I have this weird thing with albums that my favorite song on the record is always track 8, or at least it's one of my favorites. The Cycle of Always Leaving is number 8 on the album, and it was one of the first two songs that I heard from this record, maybe back in January. This and Under the Moment were the two that I heard, and I am honestly blown away. Like, this is one of my favorite songs. It's constantly stuck in my head, along with the rest of this album. If you haven't listened to it yet, you definitely should. It's a solid record, and I'm so, so proud of these guys. Start to finish, catches my attention, it keeps my attention. There's a song that reminds me of Fall Out Boy, which I know is a big influence for this band, because pretty sure it's Zach and Jake's favorite band, so obviously they're going to incorporate a lot of Fall Out Boy inspiration into an album or any of their music for the most part. Again, this record is a solid album and you guys should definitely check it out. Definitely in my top 5 of the year, so there's that one for you. Number 2 is Grayscale's album Nella Vita. I love Grayscale with my entire heart. Adornment was one of my favorite albums of 2017 or 16. I think it was 17 when it was released. I'm not entirely sure, so don't quote me on that. It was one of my favorite records, or was my favorite record of that year. This one, I love these guys. It's really hard for me to say this, but this album feels like it was just thrown together. It's all over the place and it kind of gives me a headache, but like a good headache in a way, but it's just, it loses my attention a lot. There's a lot of songs on this album that I don't necessarily care for. A lot of the songs I'm kind of confused about, but I feel like they're trying to experiment with their sound, which props to them. Like, hey, I don't really care. You guys do what you want to do. A few of the songs do sound a little the 1975 inspired. It does sound like that kind of music, which I do love. I like love the 1975, but I don't know, just the mixture of like pop punk and then throw this in there, like a little dash of that. I'm a little confused. I don't know if anyone else is feeling that way, but maybe it's just me. But this, again, is a great record. It's probably not one of my favorites of 2019. It could be up there, maybe in like top 10, but it's definitely not my top 5. But my favorites on that album are Young, Just Right, and I really like Painkiller Weather. I think that song was the perfect first single for them to release for this album because it did catch my attention. It made me want to buy the record, along with Inviolate. Old Friends I do like, it's not my favorite. And then I don't remember the last one that they released. Oops. But again, Grayscale, I love them. These songs were great to hear live. I think I liked hearing them live better than the studio versions. That's how I felt with All Time Low's last record, I believe. I don't know. A lot of the songs on that record I didn't really care for, but hearing them live, it kind of gave it a different mood to them, you know? So that's kind of how I felt about Grayscale. But yeah, so I do like the album. It's not my favorite. It's definitely not my favorite Grayscale album. It's like, to sum it up, it's all a little thrown together, a little messy, but it is what it is. It's, again, a great album, but they're always awesome to see live. Number 3 for me, and I think this might be the last album that I talk about fully, is Taylor Swift's Lover. An incredible album, first off. Start to finish, has my attention the entire time. There's a few songs I could like skip over. It is what it is. Lover, I Forgot You Existed, and Miss Americana and the Heartbreak Prince are What is going on downstairs? Those three songs are my favorite on the album. Lover just makes me, I don't want to say it reminds me of Christmas, but it reminds me of happy memories from Christmas. It just reminds me of, this whole album just makes me genuinely happy. Like, it makes me want to run through a field of sunflowers. It makes me want to see a rainbow. And I think that's just kind of how she felt while writing this record. Because the last one was really dark and very angry. And this one is just after she got off tour, as she said, and she was just on this high of like, I'm just so happy in life right now. Everything's falling into place. It's a really happy feeling record. And whenever I'm in a good mood, I listen to this album. Or if everyone would be in a better mood, I listen to this album. But Lover, I love, I Forgot You Existed makes me laugh because there's a bunch of people that I like. That song makes me think of a lot of people that I don't necessarily care for. I mean, the Miss Americana on the Heartbreak Prince, probably one of the best written songs on this record, in my opinion. But again, everything else on the album is incredible, obviously. I don't really care for The Man. I love the, there's so much noise going on. I'm so sorry. The Man, I don't really care for a lot, same with The Archer. The Man, I like what the song is talking about. I just don't necessarily like the melody, or I don't really like how, I don't know. I just, there's something about the song that I don't like, but False God is really good. Me, I thought it was funny that they took out that spelling is fun line in that song, because it kind of cracked me up, like hearing it, like, wow, this kind of makes it really kiddish and cheesy. But then they took it out and I'm just over here a little confused. Like, if you're embarrassed about having that line in the song and you decide to take it out for the final edition of your record, then why would you put it in the first place? But maybe it was just all the backlash on that song. Or that line. I don't really like Paper Rings either. It reminds me of Stay, Stay, Stay from her, whatever album it was on. It reminds me of that song. It then, I wasn't the biggest fan of it, but it is what it is. Taylor Swift, Grayscale, and Sleep On It, those albums I have been listening to nonstop recently. I've also been listening to a lot of podcasts. Well, not a lot. I've been listening to one podcast. I've been binge listening to My Favorite Murder. I have fallen in love with Karen and Georgia. I have their book. I've been reading it nonstop. I'm almost done with it. Okay, that's a lie. I'm like halfway done with it. But if you guys have any book recommendations for me, let me know in the comment section down below because I love reading. It's a good distraction from like reality, you know? Give me some recommendations because I love them. Bearings released two new songs. So Damn Wrong and I Feel It All by Bearings. Incredible. Seeing them live was really cool. I saw them open up for Grayscale along with Rich People and Belmont. I don't really listen to Belmont, but I know that they just signed to Pure Noise, I believe. I think those two songs are incredible. Bearings always surprises me because I used to not like them or listen to them, but then my friend Zach was like, hey, you should listen to them, you would like them, and obviously I ended up loving them. So it was cool seeing them live for the first time this past week. Turnover released some new music. They released two songs, Much After Feeling and Plant Sugar, which I love both of the songs. I like anything the Turnover releases. Their music's always very like soothing. It's like music I wanna listen to when I'm in the bathtub. Does that make sense? Like just kind of relaxing, but it makes you think about life. That's what Turnover's music does for me. The band Camino obviously released their EP. I'm pretty sure I talked about that in the last video. I just saw them live last night and I also got to take pictures at their concert, which was super cool. Shout out to their tour manager, Brad. I met him when he was doing merch for Microwave and then now he's like their tour manager and he's been touring with them lately and it's just like so cool to see him grow with this band. Also, This Wildlife released a new song and then Avril Lavigne did a new new rendition of one of her songs with Travis from We The Kings. That's insane. If I'm missing anything or that you think I should check out any other new music, let me know in the comment section down below because I would love to know. But yeah, that's really all I have to talk about today. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. And if you haven't listened to anything that I talked about and you are thinking about listening to it, sweet, glad I got to do something for you. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, give a thumbs up and comment down below to me your thoughts on the video and what you would like to see next. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already. I put videos out 1 to 2 times a week and you can follow me on any of my social media sites at Twitter, Instagram, or Snapchat at Subethane. It's the same way spelled on every single account. I hope you guys have a great day today and I'll see you next time. Bye.